The Tale of the Upside-Down Mermaid. Once upon a time, there was a small but incredibly smelly fishing village. And in the village lived a fisherman named Ferdig. Everyone told Ferdig it was time to pick a woman from the village with a healthy moustache and settle down. But Ferdig had other ideas. He was going to catch a mermaid and make her his wife.
What a wally!
Ferdig would set out to sea morning, noon, and night. Then, on one such night, he found himself in the middle of a huge storm. But undaunted with the wind in his face and rain pouring into his undercrackers, he heaved in the net. And to his amazement, there she was, a real-life mermaid. Okay, so an upside-down mermaid, but still, a real-life mermaid.
Woohoo!
Ferdig screamed.
A real-life mermaid! Wait till everyone gets a load of this!
Blah!
Said the mermaid. And with that, Ferdig headed for home. The next morning, invitations to an engagement party arrived on everyone's doormat. And that evening, everyone assembled at the local tavern. Everyone waited with bated fish breath, wondering who the lucky couple could be. Then, right on time, Ferdig entered arm in fin with his bride-to-be.
Ferdig?
The townsfolk stared at Blore, their eyes as wide as blowholes. You could have cut the tension with a fish knife. Just when it seemed the silence was to go on forever, Blore leapt forward and grabbed a nearby fisherman. In one fell swoop, she swiped his grog and swallowed it in one. Ferdig looked on in horror. You never swoop, swipe, or swallow another man's grog. Just when it seemed things couldn't get any worse, Blore fired two jets of grog from her gills, soaking the room. Everyone looked on in disbelief, before bursting into screams of laughter. The townsfolk celebrated late into the night. Blore drank the men under the table and told the wives dirty jokes that made them snort. Then, as the early hours drew in, while looking for dirty drawings under the tables, Ferdig bumped into Herman.
I'm proud of you, Ferdig, said Herman.
Well, I always told you I was going to marry a mermaid, didn't I?
Yeah, but she's not just a mermaid, is she?
What do you mean? Said Ferdig.
She's an upside-down mermaid.
Yes, I suppose she...
But before he could finish, he blocked, actually improving the design of the tavern's carpet.
See you at the wedding!
Herman shouted.
Shut up!
The next morning, Ferdig awoke feeling groggy. Not surprising with the amount of grog he'd drunk. Blore had made him some breakfast, but he wasn't hungry. Blore had tidied up the house, but he liked it better before. Then Blore suggested some kinky premarital sex. But Ferdig wasn't in the mood. He decided a walk might clear the kelp from his head. In the village, preparations were being made for the big day. Shutters were being painted, bunting being hung, and a huge cake was being covered in fish scales. Everyone kissed Blore on both cheeks and slapped Ferdig heartily on the back. That evening, Ferdig's cottage was a hive of activity as Blore was fussed over by her bridesmaids. Ferdig hid in his study. But when he couldn't find his pipe, he was forced to go looking. He pushed open the door to his bedroom and gasped. There, standing in her wedding dress, was Blore.
Blore?
But before Ferdig could say a word, the door slammed in his face. That night, Ferdig couldn't sleep. He couldn't stop thinking of Blore in her flowing white dress. So he got up and crept to where she was sleeping. He gently pulled back the covers to reveal Blore's face bathed in the moonlight. Blore awoke in Ferdig's boat in the middle of a huge storm.
This has all been a terrible mistake,
cried Ferdig.
You're a weirdo and a freak, and you're going back where you came from.
Suddenly, lightning shattered the sky and struck the boat's mast. The net crashed to the ground, throwing Blore across the deck, and the mast fell, trapping Ferdig underneath it. The boat started to fill with water and sink beneath the waves.
Blaw used every available ounce of strength to try and free him, but it was no use. Everything went black.
Ferdig came to in a strange room. A sea sponge moistened his brow. He turned to see Blaw by his side.
My love,
cried Ferdig.
I've been such a fool. Can you ever forgive me?
But just then, Neptune,
king of the sea, entered the room.
Has anyone seen my good trident?
Oh, you're awake, Neptune said.
I believe you know my daughter already. Quite a set of gills on her, eh?
Your Highness, I have great news, said Ferdig. Me and your daughter are to be married.
Neptune laughed.
My daughter left the kingdom to find a man to start a family with.
Yes, and I am that man, said Ferdig.
The hell you are, said Neptune, and whipped away the seaweed. Oh, come on, it's not that bad.
In the village, preparations were being made for the big day. Shutters were being painted, bunting being hung, and a huge cake was being covered in fish scales.
Do you, Herman Brian Olafson, take Blaw to be your lawful wedded half-human, half-fish wife?
I do.
And Blaw, do you take this man to be your lawful wedded trawlerman?
Blaw.
You may now kiss the bride.
No!
There's just no pleasing some people.
The end.